So in this section, we are going to talk about genome assembly using read pairs. Pavel gave great lectures explaining how to construct the Bruijn graph from reads. And from the obtained Bruijn graph, he explained how to find an Eulerian path in this graph to identify the genome. But he forgot to tell you one important thing. There can be multiple Eulerian paths in the Bruijn graph. Even in this simple Bruijn graph, there are two Eulerian paths in this graph. Here they are. And these two Eulerian paths correspond to two different strings. Which string are you going to give to biologists? The left one or the right one, or both? Please note that we sequence only one genome. Well, this ambiguity forces us to decompose the Bruijn graph into multiple disconnected components. Each component corresponds to a non-branching path in the Bruijn graph. Please note that while there are multiple Eulerian paths in the Bruijn graph, all of them share the same set of non-branching paths shown here. These non-branching paths, in their turn, correspond to contigs, which are substrings in the genome. Well, ideally, biologists would like to have one contig for each assembly, or at least one should significantly reduce the number of contigs. To obtain this goal, they invented the technology called read pair sequencing that I'm going to talk about. Given multiple identical copies of the same genome, we now randomly cut these genomes into large, equally sized fragments of size insert length. Now, for each fragment, we generate a pair of reads from both ends of each fragment. So now, instead of talking about reads individually, we are talking about a pair of reads separated by a distance called insert size. So given two cameras, if they are at a fixed distance d apart in the genome, we call them a paired camera. So the question is how to construct the genome not from the camera composition like previously described, but from paired camera composition. But what is paired camera composition? Given a string, a paired camera composition of a string is a set of all paired cameras generated from this string. Well, because we don't have space, let's represent a pair of camera as a two-line expression like this. Okay? We can order these paired cameras in this order, which is the order that they were generated from the genome. But please note that the position information is not available. So a correct way to represent the paired camera composition should be in lexicographic order, like in a dictionary. So the question now is, can you construct the string given its paired camera composition? Or let me describe formally. Input is a collection of paired cameras. Output is a string text such that the paired camera composition of text is equal to the collection of paired cameras. How would you solve this? Let's ask De Bruijn. How would he solve this problem? Well, I think that De Bruijn would come up with the same approach that I'm going to describe right now, which is the paired Bruijn graph. Given a genome and its paired camera composition, it's clear that the genome can be represented as a path where the edges are labeled by paired cameras. And the nodes can be labeled by pair of k minus 1s. And this path, we call it genome path. But allow me to do one crazy operation with this genome path. Let me glue nodes with identical labels together. In this slide, we have two nodes with identical label, TG80, We glue them, we glue, and this graph is called the paired Bruijn graph from the genome. Now, you may guess that the next question I'm going to ask is, can you construct the paired Bruijn graph? Not from the genome, but from the paired chemical compositions of the genome. Well, the answer, let's see how we solve this problem. Let's represent each paired chemicals by an hash, from the paired prefix to the paired suffix. Now, let's do the same thing as the Bruijn graph. We glue nodes with identical labels together. Here we glue, continue gluing, continue. What is it? This is the genome path, as if the genome was available. But it's not all. We have something more to glue, TGAT, there are two nodes with identical label. We have to glue them. We glue. This is the paired Bruijn graph from the read pairs. Okay, to recap, the paired Bruijn graph for a collection of paired chemicals can be constructed by two operations. First, represent every paired chemicals as an hash between its paired prefix and paired suffix. Second, glue all nodes with identical labels. In the paired Bruijn graph, the genome is an Eulerian walk in the paired Bruijn graph. But what is the point? In the Bruijn graph, we also have this property. The genome is also an Eulerian walk in this in the Bruijn graph. But please note that in the paired Bruijn graph, nodes are labeled by pair of K-1 modes. While in the Bruijn graph, nodes are labeled by just individual K-1 modes. Both of these graphs can be obtained by gluing operations on the genome path. But because of this, the difference in the labeling, paired Bruijn graph is obtained by fewer gluings. And that makes it simpler. In this case, you can see that the paired Bruijn graph is simpler than the Bruijn graph. Indeed, there's only one Eulerian path in the paired Bruijn graph that allows us to uniquely construct the genome, while the Bruijn graph, we cannot construct the genome uniquely. In practice, paired Bruijn graph has been applied in assemblers, and it has shown significant advantage in the resulting assembly.